suddenly all my business shifted to e-commerce.
Now my business hours are whenever my customers need me.
My customers want everything now and faster than ever. It's a whole different world. Your business is changing. The United States Postal Service is changing with it. We're bringing you fast, reliable shipping nationwide. And we're bringing it right where your customers need it. Let's discover new routes. Visit usps.com/new routes. The United States Postal Service. Priority. You. Text the ticket now. Ticket text 248-539-9797. 1969 issue. This is a 1970s issue, and what was the cover? This is a 1980s issue, and what was the athletic director? But Lowe, he started, became the head foot, or left football coaching in 1989 was his last name. Gary Miller was a football coach. Dr. Anderson was still in his position. Lloyd Carr was a football coach. Dr. Anderson was still in his position. We had mentioned on a number of occasions other coaches. Red Berenson. I think Red Berenson became Michigan's hockey coach. And I'm saying this off the top of my head in the 80s. Now, the great NHLer scored 6 goals in a game for the St. Louis Blues.
Turn right onto Bogey Lake Road.
Thank you. 239-9797. What are your thoughts? Love to hear from you. You're with Jim Brandstetter. By the way, just so you know Jim's background, he was on Bo's first three teams. He was on the 69, 70, and 71 teams. And obviously he's been close to the program ever since. 248-539-9797 on Pat Caputo. It's 97 won the ticket.
Two is no joke. This is where the contenders are separated from the pretenders. DraftKings Sportsbook is putting you courtside with a chance to turn $1 into $100. That's 100 to 1 odds on any basketball game. Pick any team that's still in the hunt for the trophy, and if that team wins, you'll receive $100 in free credits. Download the top-rated DraftKings Sportsbook
app now. Turn left onto Richardson Road.
Use code 97-1 the ticket when you sign up to turn $1 into $100 in free credits. Bet on the basketball team of your choice to win their next game. And if they do, you'll claim $100 in free credits. That's promo code 97-1 the ticket. For a limited time, only at DraftKings Sportsbook.
If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services Gambling Disorder Helpline at 800-270-7117. 21 and over. Michigan only. Wager paid out in site credits. Eligibility restrictions apply. See DraftKings.com/sportsbook for full terms and conditions.
So a friend told me about Mr. Clean Magic Eraser, and his exact words were, "It changed my life. I used to spend a ridiculous amount of time trying to remove tomato sauce from inside our microwave and soap scum off the bathtub. It's like seriously magic, and my secret weapon for cleaning the kitchen, bathroom, doors and walls, and even keeping my sneakers clean. Mr. Clean Magic Eraser, greatest invention ever."
Mr. Clean Magic Eraser, the unicorn of cleaning.
I'm Dr. Baker, an ER physician. If you're having lead pain, swelling, or redness, but haven't talked to your doctor yet, don't wait. This could be deep vein thrombosis, a blood clot which could travel to your lungs and lead to a pulmonary embolism, which could cause chest pain, or discomfort, or difficulty breathing.
Seen him quoted on that, as well as Kathy.
939-9797. Mike, you're on 97 on the ticket. What's up, Mike?
Hey, thanks for taking my call. You know, since this broke, I've been thinking about this. And, you know, if this started in 1969...
At the next light, turn right.
He and other coaches had the same Dr. Anderson. If they're saying there's upwards of 800 victims.
Right.
I just can't believe that any of these kids didn't go to their parents and tell them, hey, this is what happened to me. And none of these parents did anything about it?
Yeah, that's, again, there are certain things about this that, when I look at it, I'm like, well, does this fit? You know, that's one of them. Somebody's 18, 19, 20 years old, and a lot of those folks have parents that are involved in their day-to-day life, some maybe not as much.
Stay
but
in the
left lane.
It
seems like there would be that, and then some parent pushback. Now, the defense for that,
in 2 miles,
the defense
turn right into Harper.
The counter question would be, okay, somebody's got an athletic scholarship to the University of Michigan, which is like a real piece of gold. You know, how much is that worth, you know, in the course of your lifetime, right? And some of these were not in football and were athletes that would just, you know, there was no transfer portal like they have now, you know, to the same degree and all that. It's like, well, if I go forward, I lose my scholarship.
Yeah.
You know, and in some of these cases, you have to look and see whether, you know, in football, like John Vaughn was a great football player. He's come forward and said he was abused. Giovanni Johnson was a very good player. You know, some of these players that have come forward were very good players. But some players that may have been abused maybe weren't so good players, and their scholarships depended, you know, it might have felt it depended on not, you know, making a squeaky wheel, so to speak.
The other thing that bothers me is Bolt's wife, Millie.
Yes.
Went to Cannon and reported. So Cannon said, I'll take care of it.
Yeah, that's what the
reports said. Never happened. And so I question why Millie even stayed with Bolt. He was watching his kid and not doing nothing about Dr. Anderson.
Right. And so, there are things to me that, again, why is this Bo the only name that's mentioned? Right?
Yeah.
Okay? Why not these other coaches who are alive that can counter-sue? Why is it just Bo? The other thing is, you know, with the situation that you're mentioning,
really,
by all accounts, right? All accounts was highly respected, a beloved figure in her own right, you know, why would she stick with somebody who did this to her child? Now, somebody might counter, you know, back. Again, it goes to the back in the day thing. Well, women at the time, you know, were often deferential, you know, at the time. And, you know, they were subjected to abuses that were egregious, that were often happening behind closed doors. And it was a different time. I don't know if that's a defense or whatever, but that's, again, you know, where it becomes very complex and nuanced, Mike, and, you know, I don't have the answers to it, you know.
Wouldn't you think in this big report that they compiled and have issued, did they not interview Lloyd Carr or Webb Berenson or Gary Moore?
lot of, you know, his wife just passed. He had his grandson die, you know, a few years back with the, you know, horrific, you know, disease that, you know, it's just, you know, I mean, so I don't know, you know, what Lloyd thinks. Well, you know, I knew Gary Moeller very well. I don't know Lloyd Carr real well, other than the news conferences, but I knew Moeller well because he was a coach of the Lions. He was assistant coach for a long time, at a time when you really got to know the assistant coaches. And I really, really,
arrived.
You know, look at Gary Moeller with very high regard. I can't imagine Gary Moeller looking at this, and even as an assistant coach, or Lloyd Carr, what I know about him. You know, from what I've heard from so many people, like sitting there going, hey, this, you know, this is going on, and, you know, I know about it, and I'm going to let it go. And why isn't they mentioned?
Yeah, exactly. It just doesn't make a lot of sense. I'll tell you that.
So
thanks for taking my call.
Yeah, I appreciate it. And now, again, right, I want to make this perfectly clear that a lot of the things that keep people from coming forward